Thank you.
Thank you so much. I'm so glad you're here. You know, traditionally, the jazz band has their warm-up pieces. Yeah, those of you who are familiar with our jazz ensemble know that we play a piece to get us warmed up. And I thought, what a wonderful way for the orchestra to play together for the first time, just two beautiful classic carols, just very simply, as a way for us to warm up tonight and to welcome you to our winter concert. Well, they did a really wonderful job. Thank you. So, the first piece that we're going to play is going to be introduced by Tristan, and she's going to come up and talk a little bit about it, and then we're going to jam on it.
All right. Hello, everybody. Yeah, thanks for coming out. So, the first piece we're playing is Cossack March by Franz Liszt, and this is an excerpt from the symphonic poem number 6 called Mazeppa. And this piece is one of 13 other symphonic poems by this composer, and each of these helped establish a genre called program music, which is when music is used to like invoke an image, tell a story, or imitate another piece of art through sound. So this story in particular tells the tale of Hugo Mazeppa and his heroic and unusual journey, to say the least. I recommend you read it on Wikipedia in your spare time or something. So for each of these poems, Franz Liszt wrote a preface to set the scene for the listeners, and this one in particular, he just used the last stanza about the poem that was written to tell this tale. And so I hope you enjoy this heroic journey and the rest of our concert. Thank you.
Thank you.
Our next person to introduce is Galen.
Good evening, everyone. Our next piece is by Jean-Baptiste Lully. Clemence, that was for you. So Lully was a 17th century French composer who was a favorite of King Louis XIV. Now, he wrote some really masterful Baroque music, a piece of which we're going to be playing for y'all today. But probably what he's most memorable for is the way he died. Now, Lully, when he liked to conduct, he liked to supplement his conducting with a big stick that he would bang on the floor to keep the time. So in one such performance, Lully was banging on the floor with the stick, got a little too into it, and he accidentally hit his own foot. The wound became infected, and the infection killed him. So, true story. So when we were rehearsing this piece pretty early on, Mr. Bradley is like, man, there's something missing from this piece. And he's like, you know, we're really missing that stick sound. So now, I know what you're thinking, don't worry. None of the people behind me are crazy enough to go leave rehearsal without telling anyone, go down out into the parking lot, scour over the trees, find a giant stick, haul it back up to the orchestra room, and present it to Mr. Bradley. So don't worry, I did that. So, unfortunately, we had to retire the stick. So no stick. But my man Charlie, back there, he will be simulating the stick sound on his drum back there, so be sure to listen for that. And enjoy le bourgeois gentil.
Thank you.
So the next piece, one of our favorites, is going to be introduced by Angela.
Hi, everyone.
Hi,
hello. So this piece we're going to play is called House Moving Castle, and it's from a movie that's of the same name. It tells a story about this young girl, whose name is Sophie, and she was turned into an old woman by this evil witch. And she met this really, really handsome wizard called Hal, who lives in the castle. And this castle's magic. It can take you up to the sky and deep down into the ocean, from mountains to grass. It can take you anywhere. So if you turned your program into the front cover, that's Hal's Moving Castle. And playing this piece is really special to me, because as a pianist, you don't really get to play the same music with your fellow pianists, because there's only one piano in an orchestra. So I want to say thank you so much to Melinda Yin, who wonderfully rearranged this piece from a piano solo to a four-handed piano piece. So then I get a chance to share this amazing journey with one of my best friends, Mingyu. And as pianists, you don't really get to do that. So thank you so much, Melinda, for doing this. And please enjoy Hal's Moving Castle.
This will be our last piece before we make a huge change and the jazz band comes back. So feel free to stretch your legs after. But I must tell you, I'm really, really proud of our musicians. They've been playing exceptionally well, and you'll be amazed with this last piece. So thank you for being such a good artist. Thank you. So, we were going to play something called The Box, which is very easy to play, that they learned in middle school. But every time I get ready to play with the jazz band, I feel that losing such a great musician like that is like something tearing a hole in the soul of music. So, it's my way of paying respects to that. It's pretty amazing. So, starting on that note, and thinking about like how can we play music that's exciting and cool and fun, we're gonna play a piece by a Philadelphian, Grover Washington Jr. And our first person to introduce this is gonna be Jacob.
Right. So, as Mr. Bradley just said, this is a piece by Grover Washington Jr. And it's from his fourth album called Mr. Manager, which, if you've been to jazz band concerts before, there's another song off of that album which we love playing. This particular album came out in 1975, and it hit number one on the charts for soul, jazz, and even made it to the top 10 for pop. So this was an incredible album. This piece is an incredible song, and when we get to the solo section, the reason that I think this piece is so incredible for our jazz band is we just go down the line and everyone plays a bit. And it's just so perfect of a way to start what will be a fantastic concert. And I hope that you all enjoy it as much as we enjoy playing it. Thank you.
Hi everybody. So 2017 has been a very special year for many reasons. But for our purposes, it's particularly special because it's the Thelonious Monk, the famous jazz pianist, would have turned 100 this year. So when I think of one particular Thelonious Monk piece, I think of one, which is the song that we're playing. It's called Think of One. So we hope you like it.
And one of the first times we played this in rehearsal, Mr. Bradley told a story about how John Coltrane, early in his career, he was in Miles Davis's group, and he was suffering from a pretty bad drug addiction, and he was really unreliable, just in general. And one day, Miles called him up and said it was like he just got too bad, and he couldn't play with the group anymore. So that disturbed Coltrane so much that he just quit like cold turkey, and he went through really bad. That's a really, really rough process. And during that process, he said he heard the voice of God, and he sort of went through a spiritual, removal. And Mr. Bradley told us that if Miles had never made that call, then we definitely wouldn't be playing this song today. And I think one of the reasons why we picked this song is because it's called In a Sentimental Mood. And around this time of the year, we all get pretty sentimental. Just the holiday season, and also the seniors, Annie, Tristan, Jacob, and I, we're all pretty sentimental about college is coming up, and that's like one of the biggest goodbyes we have to say in our lives. So we all get pretty sentimental about this. So I think it was extra fitting this year. Thank you.
every concert that we play, we always play something that's impossible. I'm serious. And the next piece that Tristan is introducing is one of those pieces.
That's a very good introduction to what I'm about to say. Okay, so the next piece we are going to play for you is off Charles Mingus's album, The Black Saint and the Sinner Lady. He released it in 1963, and the entire album is just a continuous composition, but it is broken up into four movements, and the piece we're playing for you tonight is track A, Solo Dancer, the first movement. I chose this piece because it means so much to me. It's particularly ominous and mysterious, and it's really something I have never heard before, and I'm pretty sure that's true for most of you tonight. This is going to be something insane. This piece came to me in a time of a lot of change, and when I showed this to my dad, my sister and I were in the car, and he told us he could die happy knowing that we chose something so insane and that his job was finished, that he had gifted us a love of music so much that we found this on our own and actually came to him with something he has never heard before. And like, death, happiness is just an odd juxtaposition, and this piece is kind of like that to me. Because it is so mysterious, but it's so beautiful, and I really think, I'm really happy Mr. Bradley encouraged us to play this, because when I showed it to him and we listened to it, I think he thought I was insane. Yeah, okay, he did. But I'm absolutely amazed that we all pulled it together, and this has been such a transformative experience. I've gotten so much closer with this piece, and I've got to see how it works and pulls together each part of it, and I think it's really helped and together as one, because this piece is almost impossible, but we're able to get through it because each of us holds our weight, and I think it really brought us together to perform this, and I can't be more happy to be playing with each of you guys. All right, so I hope you enjoy it.
difficult this was to put together. The drums is playing in four at the beginning, so it's going doot. And we're in three, so we're going one, two, one, two. So this is all happening at the same time. And then at one point, he has to switch into a waltz kind of rhythm. And then there we go into, we go into an amazing four section, the beautiful trumpet section that Tristan plays so beautifully. Not are we? Oh, it's gorgeous. Please give her a round of applause. I just have a few things to say, and I promise it won't be long, because I want to hand this over to Annie so she can introduce our last piece. But I, throughout the night, I just see heroic efforts from my students. Absolutely unbelievable. We just heard tonight Duke Ellington's solo played on our piano by Evan. I was trying to think about how many lessons I've learned this year. I once watched this film, and it was saying that a child is like a perfect teacher for an adult. Like, and I was thinking, like, yes, that's true. Because several weeks ago, we had gotten to a place where we could play the piece, but Evan wasn't ready to do this. And I was like, well, don't worry about it. It's okay. You have other things you have to do. He plays Chopin, Debussy. You have to practice. So he said, I'll see you on Monday and I will have it done. And I was like, please don't. And then I get to school on Monday and he says, here's my transcription. And there are moments like that as a teacher. You gotta step out of the way and just let your students be the amazing human beings that they are. Creative individuals that they are. And like maybe what you're seeing isn't really what's there. Like you see barriers sometimes, you see like, well maybe not this. But what was so beautiful about that was when Evan played it for the first time for our jazz ensemble, and there was several people pointing to him in awe, but also thanking him. And we all burst out in applause. That's the kind of jazz band that we have. And I hope that as they go through their lives, they're always searching for places, people that are just as supportive, and also see when you've done something that's really pretty extraordinary. And that's just one of several that has happened this year. And I feel so fortunate that we're going to get a chance to play one more song for you. And this one, Annie's going to introduce. But again, I just would like you all to give this unbelievable ensemble another round of applause.
But that's also been one of the most intense jazz bands there's ever been. And Mr. Bradley told us a story once about how whenever they would perform the band and one of the musicians would make a mistake, James Brown would actually fine his musicians. So I'm really glad that doesn't apply to this band because we all gain serious debt. But just to talk a little bit about the band, we call this piece our stand-up piece. And every year we have a stand-up song. And that song's usually one of the songs that just makes us want to stand up and dance when we play it. So The Chicken, I chose this piece because every time I listen to it, it really just makes me want to stand up and dance, and the band feels the same way, I think. So I hope you kind of feel that, and I hope you enjoy the last song, and thank you so much for coming out and listening to us.
Thank you so much for coming tonight. Drive safely home, okay?